Welcome to the first Powerbomb of 2018. We are sitting here as we speak. I believe we are 20 some odd days from the Rumble, and I will be doing a preview for the Rumble and the Rumble itself, of course. But this is a special one. I put out on Twitter and asked it, or Twitter, Facebook, and asked if you guys wanted to see some of my predictions for wrestling in 2018, and the response to that was overwhelmingly positive, so you guys are getting what you asked for. For a start, just want to say thanks for the positive response. I try to kind of gear this or everything I do to what the people want to see, because I am a man of the people. So, without any further ado, let's get to some predictions. I think 2018 has the potential to be a banner year for some people, and I think the breakout star of 2018, I'm gonna go ahead and take a flyer on Mojo Rawley, because this motherfucker has it. I don't know what it is, but whatever it is, he has it. I don't think that he should have been the one to be turned in the Hype Bros split, but I love the renewed focus that he's showing, and I think eventually fans will turn him back into a babyface, and he can basically just keep doing, you know, keep his focus and keep doing what he's doing, basically, but he'll get cheered for it. So that should happen. I wouldn't say, wouldn't be too long, I don't think. So I think that at the end of 2018 will be, when you look at breakout stars, top of the list, it's going to be Mojo. I think the current U.S. title tournament, I would like to see him and Jinder in the final, because they can kind of play off of that interaction that they had in the Andre the Giant Battle Royal last year, and really WWE doesn't do too much heel stuff, so you know, I'd kind of like to see that. I think it could work, and alright, prediction for Tag Team of the Year. God almighty. And as a disclaimer, much as I'd like to say the Revival, they haven't been around enough in 2017 for me to be able to make that determination, so that automatically eliminates them. I am, however, open to having my mind change by the end of the year, so but I'm gonna go ahead and say you know what, I'm gonna tie this one. I'm gonna say Benjamin and Gable, and Rusev and Aiden English, if they're still around as a team by the end of 2018. I know I'm not supposed to love them, but God damn it, I do. You know, Rusev's personality hides Aiden English's weaknesses, and Aiden don't really have that many weaknesses to hide anyway. So, you know, it's gonna be a tie for me, I think, with those two teams for Team of the Year. Most improved, I think, will probably end up being, there again, Aiden English. He's working with Rusev, so, and that can do nothing but help him, I think. So I think he'll be the most improved. Female Superstar of the Year. Everybody says, you know, throws out Sasha, Charlotte, Bayley, all those types. I'm gonna make a bold prediction here. I'm gonna predict Ruby Riott, actually. Because I think she's got, again, that it that you don't know what it is, but you know whatever it is, she's got it. I think she is not well served, personality wise too. You don't see it right now because she's trying to be the leader of a group, but once they split them away from each other, I think you'll see more of that personality and what I've known about her since OVW. I think she has potential to be a big star, and yeah, so that's my prediction for Female Superstar of the Year. NXT call-ups, by the end of 2018, I'd say you're gonna see all three guys in the Undisputed Era. Aleister Black, Velveteen Dream, probably too, at some point, and there may be, you know, a couple of surprises. I don't think we see Kairi Sane up on the main roster for good until sometime in 2019. She may make an appearance in the Rumble coming up, but after that, I don't think we see her in a full-time spot on the main roster until sometime early in 2019, maybe. Let's see. Show of the Year. And again, this is kind of predicting without knowing what the cards are going to look like. But traditionally, Mania has been pretty great the last couple of years, so you can go ahead and call that as show of the year for 2018. We'll see what happens. What else? Oh yeah, Graves is gonna take commentator of the year, hands down. I think also, given the current storyline arcs, I think sometime in 2018, we see Bryan Danielson in a WWE ring. I don't care what they tell you. If they find out he is going to go somewhere else and wrestle, and they're gonna miss out on, you know, all those pay-per-view buy or all those, you know, all those subscriptions to the network to see that, and you know, all that extra revenue, they won't let it happen. So I think, given the storyline arc sometime in 2018, I think we see Bryan in the ring. If not, at first one with Shane, I think maybe you see him in a tag match with AJ or a Nakamura, or Kevin Owens or Sami Zayn, to face Shane and somebody else, and something goes down, and Shane goes all the way heel, and that leads to an eventual one-on-one between him and Shane. I can see that so happening. Let's see, what else? I think also, and this is the last prediction I'm going to make for 2018, and it had to do with the women on the rosters. I think that sometime late 2018, maybe even leak into early 2019, but I think most likely late 2018, I think that we do eventually end up getting women's tag straps. I think there are enough people on both rosters to justify it. I think you don't make them Raw or SmackDown exclusive. You just let the girls float between both shows. And there are definitely enough girls on the rosters now to justify that. So I think sometime late 2018, maybe leaking into 2019, early 2019, like I said, we'll see women's tag straps. Anyway, that's just a few predictions that I have for 2018. They're probably all gonna turn to shit and prove that I don't know anything. But going into it, that's kind of what I think. And it'll be interesting to see what actually does happen, if any of these come true, or if they don't, or even if some of them come true part of the way, or not exactly, you know, or totally different than I predicted, but they still end up coming true. So anyway, thanks for watching, thanks for listening, love y'all, couldn't do what I do without you, so peace.